style in a more realist fashion compared to Ensor, but it's also a delight in the indelicate, the improper, the, well, underbelly. And there's a sort of general connection I think you could make with this work that's, of course, precedes that of Lautrec here in the 1890s. Here's an interesting etching by Ensor, guy urinating in the street, in the wall. And look, yes, it's a guy in a top hat, a well-dressed man of the Bouvardier out there relieving himself. And here on the wall, this is part of Ensor's inspiration, the scrawls, graffiti on the walls, in the street, in the gutter, if you will. There's an aspect of primitivism to Ensor, isn't there? In the untutored-looking, graffiti-like representations of humanity in the entry of Christ into Brussels, that painting we just saw a moment ago. How is this different from the primitivism of, let's say, Picasso, seeking inspiration in the purportedly crude, untutored work of African art? Or Matisse, looking to his daughter Marguerite's childish representations and taking them as a source of inspiration for his portrait in 1906 of Marguerite, if you remember that. How is this different from the primitivism we've looked at previously, be it in Picasso or Matisse or S. Ludwig Kirchner? How is this different? Yes.
Does it because of the humor in it?
Well, okay. What's the humor about? Is it, oh, let's all laugh together?
Maybe it's a little...
It's like an attack, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's barbed humor, right? It's not Mickey Mouse. It's a different kind of humor. It's... and, you know, is Picasso using African sculpture to mock humanity, to denigrate anything? No, he admires it, right? Does Ensor really admire this art or use it to defame what he wants? I'll give you crudity right in your face using this kind of art. It's attack. It's not, he doesn't really consider these kinds of caricatures as, let's say, things to be looked up to, but tools to satirize society. Yes? It is primitivism, but it's with a different purpose in mind, is it not?